So is this me concept clear to everybody? I and me? Okay, now I ask the question. Is I and me same?
No.
Me is the mask which is taken by I. Temporary, unreal. Okay? I mean, you can think that I goes through a dream. In the dream, you become a dream body. Like that, me is taken. Who takes the dream body?
I
only takes the dream body, but I is not affected. It is exactly like this. You are sleeping, and in sleep, you start suddenly, you become a dream girl and go to Paris. Who goes to Paris is the sleeping only. But sleeping girl is not affected by Paris. She sleeping one doesn't even know that Paris exists. Similar situation with the Shiva and Jiva. Shiva only takes the form of Jiva. Shiva doesn't know Jiva exists also. It just takes a dream-like structure. And Jiva doesn't know Shiva exists. Only when Guru comes and Shiva says Jiva is Shiva, then they become one. Ashte.
So how does the entire situation gets created, entire being? It's not Shiva, it's not Jiva.
See, there is no dream. There never was a dream, okay? So when you ask the question, already the dream is created by asking the question. The mind creates that structure.
Then the mind itself is not there.
See, it's all perceptions. Perception is not real, but it appears to be real. Okay. Let us take the me is clear now. So what is the role of me? Me is there for experiencing. Okay? Me is there for doing. Me is for action. Your me is body mind is for the action. It's as good as saying me is the vehicle. Okay? Are you clear?
If it was only like washing machine, it would have been good, but you have put a lot of emotions and unnecessary stuff into that.
Otherwise, how will there be fun entertainment?
There's no entertainment.
Drama is required. See, otherwise life will be bland. So it should be colorful. If it's bland
you
life,
have emotions, but you are also enjoying.
Do you go to any movies which are nothing but a bland story?
No, I like action movies.
So the action is required. Life has required action. Life requires emotions. So it's like that. It's a part of entertainment program. Okay, now let us look at it. So me is the experiencing body and mind intellect, and it is the world. Right? Okay. So whatever world you see is nothing but it, that. The table, the chair, the fan. Who takes the form of it? I only takes the form of it. In your dream, you went to Paris. Who is Paris? You only as the Paris. In Kanasar Paris, you went to dream Paris in a dream Paris. In your dream, okay, you went to Paris. Mm. Are you the dream girl in the dream?
Yes.
Who is Paris there?
Listen, so our imagination.
Your mind. Your mind takes the form of a dream girl and mind takes the form of Paris.
Imagine.
Other than the mind, something is there, right?
No.
Paris is made up of a stuff called mind. You are made of a stuff called mind. Similarly, the world is made up of a stuff called mind. Mind is just made up of a stuff called consciousness. Okay? Divya?
But many things, places and people that I have not seen also come into my dreams.
That is why it is not your dream. It is God's dream. Universal consciousness dreams.
But sometimes my mother also comes.
That's your individual. Universal consciousness takes the dream, creates all the bodies, takes the body of Gayatri, experiences. In that experience, it has some relationship. Those come as your personal dream and as a part of the universal dream. They are mixed up.
You told God's dream.
Mm-hmm.
What do you mean by that?
What is God? What is God?
Consciousness.
Consciousness. Don't go by definition of God which you learned in society. consciousness of God. Okay? So, let me ask you. Are you able to see this cup of glass? Where are you seeing?
Consciousness.
You are, this is appearing in your consciousness. If you don't have consciousness, this glass of cup of glass can be seen. Where is the world?
In our mind.
Where is the mind?
Consciousness.
The world is also appearing in consciousness. If it doesn't appear in consciousness, if there is no consciousness, there is no world. If there is no consciousness, there is no mind. There is no mind, there is no world. Right? Is everything appearing in consciousness? Is there a single thing which is not appearing in consciousness? Think things which you are not seeing. Just imagine, I will tell an animal. Coo, coo, coo. That animal is there in Africa. Okay? Is it in your consciousness?
Now it is.
Yes.
It is. There's not a single thing in world which is not in consciousness. Even the world thinks which you are not seeing. Right? Is it clear to you or not?
Oh, you mean to say inside the dream, the mind is creating then and there, which I have not seen also.
Which I is what we will find out. Okay?
Which the mind has not seen.
Are we clear now? Everything is appearing in consciousness. Moon. Where is moon?
Space.
Where is space?
Consciousness.
The mind.
Where is the mind?
Consciousness.
The moon is in my consciousness. So now if I say God is all pervading, do you have any objection?
No.
Consciousness is all pervading. Do you have any objection? And who is this consciousness?
I.
This is not even. Right? Are you understanding? The consciousness is all pervading. That's why our definition of God in our Vedas is Sat-Chit-Ananda. Consciousness is God. Other people will say a lot of things. Finally, the Veda says consciousness is God, which is called Shiva. So, is the world appearing in consciousness? The small atom, molecule appears in consciousness. Everything is appearing in consciousness. And who is that consciousness? That's Shiva. You have a problem in understanding that you are Shiva? When you feel uncomfortable? Shiva is somewhere, I don't have a problem because he will handle the problem. So, Shiva and consciousness, they mean one and the same thing. Which is you. Okay? Consciousness is all pervading. Oh, I want to see all pervading. Yes, where is the star? In your consciousness. Where is the atom? In your consciousness. Is it clear?
Can we control our dreams?
Now the question is, who is I? You cannot control your dream unless you understand who is I. You are actually mixing up. When you say, can I control I, who is that I asking the question? A movie screen is, movie show is going on, movie. The characters are coming in the movie. Okay? So the movie character, one character is getting killed. The character says, can I control this movie and I don't want to get killed. Can you do that?
It's already been directed.
It's already been directed. But director can change it. Right now, me is a character in the movie. I is the director. So if you ask the question, who has to answer?
I
has to.
As I, you can change. As me, you are a part of the dream. Are you able to understand? Yes or no?
Yes.
Clear? Okay. So, it means the world which you experience also is consciousness only. The consciousness appearing as matter. The consciousness appears as mind and matter. Mind means me and matter means the world. Are we clear? Experiencer and experienced. Both are appearance of consciousness. Appearance of. Are we clear? Have you seen that? Shown that? So, the same I appears as it also. The the donkey, monkey, the enemy, the character, everything you see on the movie screen or in the world are also same I appearing as that. Consciousness. So, what is the difference between I never changes, me keeps changing, moment to moment. But do you live, what illusion do you live with the? I am same Pushpa. The Pushpa 1 minute back is different from Pushpa 1 minute now. Are you able to understand? The me keeps on changing. But we don't notice the change, that's a different thing. But it's a continuous change. Right? But we think that I am the same. You are 50% right, 50% wrong. What is that same? I is same. Me is changing. Using I, you are saying I am the same.
You're always mixing I and
me. I and me, you are mixing up very badly. Does me have a choice?
No.
Me doesn't have a choice.
I doesn't need a choice.
I doesn't need a choice. So me has appeared and disappeared. So I want to change. That guy has already changed. But for us, oh, I am not changed. The feeling is there. But the reality is I has not changed. The me has changed.
In I, the me can be changed.
Huh?
In the state of I, the me can be changed.
Yeah, but in the state of I, the me is not at all there.
No, like that time you told, when the deep silence, the answer comes from consciousness. So
as an instrument of I have the ability to change. We'll find out. Okay? I itself is not bothered, no? I itself doesn't know anything. So it is changing moment to moment. You have shown this? Okay. Constantly, it's continuously changing. Now who are you? I or me? But then why are you living in the illusion that me is I? Me is made up of I. But me cannot be I. Gold ornament is made up of gold. But ornament is not gold. Stone is made up of consciousness. But stone is not consciousness. So let us understand the difference between this is subject form, right? Let us understand the again little bit more detail. There is a subject pronoun, it's called I, object pronoun me, and object which is I. Object is an apple. I eat an apple. I am experiencing apple. Is that correct? Shall we? So between me, object pronoun, and this is not object pronoun, it's object actually. Here is object. So, me is used for experiencing. Without me, there's no experience. Correct?
Yes, sir.
It's as good as saying, if you go to a 3D movie, without 3D goggles, there's no 3D character on the screen. Okay? So, for the eye, your body, mind and intellect is a goggle. And with this body, mind and intellect, the experience takes place. apple is experienced. Correct? So what is the relationship between the subject, object pronoun and object? Me and object. Me is used, me is the experiencing, is used for experiencing. By whom?
I.
The consciousness. Even though I has no botheration, it creates me and I, it for experiencing. And it takes the form of me also. It takes form of it also to experience. So who is experiencing whom?
Nobody.
Consciousness consciousness is experiencing itself. Right? Consciousness is experiencing itself. In your dream, you went to Paris. Can I say, in your dream, Sharadi's mind experiences Paris in the form of Sharadi? Sharadi's mind only experiences Paris. Sharadi had a dream. The dream body of Sharadi is nothing but created by Sharadi's mind. Paris is created by Sharadi's mind. Who is experiencing now? Mind is experiencing itself.
In various forms.
In various forms. Is there Paris? Is there Sharadi in the dream? Sharadi and Paris is experienced by mind. Who is experiencing what now? Mind is experiencing itself. Clear? Consciousness or I is experiencing itself in all the forms. In the infinite forms. Are you clear? Okay.
Guruji, when I itself is a consciousness, why it needs to experience?
See, it doesn't experience, my dear. A dream is appearing that. Like a person, you are sleeping, you are dreaming, you are sleeping, right? You are sleeping on the bed and relaxed. A dream appears. In the dream, your body appears and the Paris appears. Now, is dreamer affected in that? One who is sleeping, he doesn't even know the Paris is there. He doesn't even know that dream body. This mind is able to create that. The mind is the power of consciousness. Chaitanya. It is creating. Now nobody is there to stop it. It just creates. What? What happened?
That was a genuine question. Why I wants to experience?
I doesn't want to experience. I has a power. Okay? The problem with the power is that it cannot keep quiet now. It keeps on doing something. The power of consciousness is Shiva, is called Shakti. It has a power. You like it or not. The Shakti's job is only to create concepts. Imagine.
Does it mean Shakti is mind?
Shakti takes the form of mind. Shakti is?
Energy.
Shakti takes all the forms. Okay? That is the power of consciousness. So, this question is why consciousness, it's already blissful now, why you should do something? It is blissful, but it has a power. What to do with the power, right? The power is doing something.
So, we can't stop it, like, no dreams today.
Who is we?
Me.
Consciousness.
Who is asking the question?
Okay.
The more you understand who is asking the question, the dreams will stop. Okay? The more you ask the question, then you will become less of Sharadi and more of Shiva. Shiva has no dreams. The power of consciousness is Shakti, which is the imagination, creativity. It will keep on creating. Okay. In that creation, the world is appearing. But is Shiva affected by that? Consciousness affected by that? Not. Shakti is Maya. Okay, it's like snake has a poison. The poison which is there, snake is in the mouth. It will never affect the snake. It will affect everybody else. The Maya affects every form, but it doesn't affect Shiva. Right? So the question is, who are you? If you keep on thinking that I am body, mind, I am Jiva, then you are the domain of Maya. Then you have no choice. You are subject to Maya. Then you constantly understand who am I, then you go to domain of Shiva, then Maya will not affect you. Right? Is this much clear, Paula?
So we worship Maya, which is Shakti Swarupini.
No, we are not worshipping Maya. We are worshipping Maya, Shiva in the form of Maya.
Shiva in the form of
Maya. Everything is basically Shiva only. Consciousness only. When you do you go to a government office, you do an IAS officer, you do Namaskara. Actually, you're not doing IAS officer, you're doing the government.
Hmm.
Shiva is not the ideal form,
idol. The idol is a representation, no?
But if you tell Shiva, we'll just get that symbol.
Mm-hmm. That's because, how many years of your life you are conditioned like that? Huh? 18 years you have been made to believe that is Shiva. That's also Shiva to begin with. But gradually you will understand who is real Shiva. Because if you are a kid, then if I tell what is Shiva, you are Shiva, then Shiva child with the kid will not understand. So for that, a Shiva is required. These are beginnings.
Correct. Probably now alligi nils puttivi insata. Mundin tilkodalla.
Mundin tilkobekala.
Adike we get confused.
Who is we?
Primary education alli nils puttidive.
Undo kada.
Correct.
That is the reason earlier days there was a gurukula, a guru, kula guru.
Hmm.
Okay, kula guru is for every family decision they will consult the guru.
Hmm.
The decisions. It's not like horoscope and all. So the guru is supposed to be a wise man. If I don't know, at least I have to consult wise man. Now we don't even know that there is somebody called a wise man exists on the earth. Everybody, I think everybody is like me only. Okay, so from here we have to go to
you said you'll tell about memories and thoughts.
Next. Sometime we'll tell. So, I am Shiva. Is this clear to all of you? The I is Shiva. The am is the body is the vehicle. It's the me. Never confuse I and me. Me cannot exist without I. I can exist without me. Okay? The nature of I is peaceful. The nature of me is disturbed. Why it is disturbed? Me thinks I am separate and individual. I have full freedom. Me has no freedom. A screwdriver or a cutting player, does it have any freedom? Is me any different from that? But me has an illusion of freedom. I am free to do anything.
And I can control anything.
I can control anything. That's why Krishna told Arjuna in Bhagavad Gita, Nimitta Matram Bhavasavya Sachin. Oh Arjuna, don't bother, don't think that you, these people are getting killed because of you.
Hmm.
You are just an instrument. This body, mind and complex is just an instrument of God, consciousness. Okay? So if you live with that attitude, our life will be beautiful. I can live as me, but me as an instrument of consciousness when you are operating in the world. So right now is me instrument? Ah.
After coming to you.
Yes.
Me? What all we do for this me, you tell me.
You said that it's an instrument of consciousness. But why would consciousness want to do anything through something?
I gave the answer already. The consciousness doesn't do anything. The power of consciousness does something. Shakti.
There's a power.
The fire doesn't want to burn anybody, my dear. You put your finger there. Fire thinks you, do you think fire wants to burn your finger? It doesn't know, you know your finger. Okay? Fire has no hatred on you. Why should it burn your finger? But you put the finger into fire, what will happen? Burn.
Yeah.
The fire has an ability to burn. Okay, are we living our life as instrument of God?
No.
but still, you know, crime maadidavarge, somebody murder somebody else, ಅದು ನಿಮಿತ್ತ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅವನು ಸಾಯ್ಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಅದು
ಅಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಎ ಟಾಕ್ ವೆರಿ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಮಿನ್ನೇಸೋಟಾ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಹಿಂದೂ ಟೆಂಪಲ್ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ವಾಚ್ ಇಟ್ ಸಿ ದಿ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಇಂಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ಡಸ್ ಎ ಮಿಸ್ಟೇಕ್. Once he thinks that I am the instrument of God, no mistakes will happen from him. It's like a virus which has got into your computer. The computer virus will make it go haywire. If the computer, no virus free, then the computer will work properly. If you understand I am the instrument of God, no crime will happen from him. No, nobody will do any crime. That's what Ramakrishna Paramahamsa says.
But how do we treat somebody who has committed a crime?
I have given two lectures on this.
Okay.
Very, there are two lectures in two Hindu temples. Three lectures, totally three lectures. They are all related to this only. Okay. Right? There are different audience, but then I have communicated to them why, how we treat. So, now let us understand this, the awareness, what is the role of awareness and what is the role of me? Me is an instrument for experiencing, right? So you have many experiences in life. Experience one, experience two. Every moment they say experience change. Variety of experiences. So this I call as experience one, experience two, experience three, experience n. You can see that? Experiencing is happening. Okay?
It needs to be changed.
Where?
Which is shooting. Person
awareness.
Subject prone.
So, the awareness or I and me, you have to understand the difference and role. The me comes up and goes. Okay? Me appears. Yesterday you had a different me actually. Yesterday there was a different Pushpa. The consciousness doesn't like to have same person every day. Yesterday's person Pushpa is gone. Today morning new Pushpa is created. Next moment another Pushpa will be created. But he does it so quickly that you don't understand that he already changed this. Such a fashion conscious. Sky. Yesterday night when you slept, Kirti is gone. Me. Okay? Became pure consciousness, Shiva. Morning Shiva gets up, Shakti comes into picture. She says, no, today you'll have a new dress, a new Kirti comes into picture. New body mind. Okay? Next moment, another dress. So Shakti's job is only worshipping Shiva. How she worships, he keeps on changing the dress of Shiva moment to moment so that Shiva has a new experience. This is the meaning of, actually we have heard that Lakshmi doing service of Narayana, Pada Seva. Okay, Parvati is doing service of Shiva, means this one only. She keeps on decorating Shiva with different bodies, moment to moment.
But there is no experiencer.
See, there is a me one and experience one, it one. Let me eat one, maybe apple, it two, maybe mango, it two, maybe lecture. So different experiences are happening. Experience one, experience two, experience ten, experiences are happening. Moment to moment. Is it correct? What does consciousness do? It simply knows, knowing. Okay, this experience is happening. Knowing is there. Experiences keep changing, but knowing doesn't change. Experience is there, consciousness knows the experience is there. Experience is not there, consciousness, there's no experience is there. For example, waking state, dream state, you have some experiences. You know that there's an experience. In deep sleep state, there's no body, there's no mind, there's no world. There's knowing of no world. There's knowing of no experience. There's knowing of peace. The knowing never changes. You understand? That's called awareness. What is awareness? To another way of saying, awareness is the ability to know. For example, this glass, I am aware of this glass. But glass is not aware of me, because glass is inert, unconscious. Are you clear? I am aware of glass, but glass is not aware of me. That's meaning of consciousness, awareness. So now I think me is the body. Okay? So now I'll ask the question. Are you aware of the body? Yes. So I am aware of the body. Body is not aware of me.
I am aware of the
breath. Correct. Okay? I am aware of the breath, but breath is not aware of me. I am aware of the mind. How are you aware of the mind? Oh, I am thinking too much. Who is thinking too much? Me is thinking too much. I am aware of the me. My mind is not running at all. I don't know. I can't think. So the I knows thinking is happening. Thinking is not happening. I knows there's experience. I knows there's no experience. I is simply knowing. Is it a knower? It's not a knower. It's simply knowing. Knower has a history.
Knower also. Okay.
Knower has a history. Knowing has no history. It doesn't even remember what has happened. See, just experiencing. See, knowing. This moment. Okay, Pushpa, new Pushpa has come. Yesterday's Pushpa is old. Okay, replaced.
Gotaitappa.
Gotaitappa. So tomorrow, new Pushpa, Gotaitappa. Knowing. So that is consciousness, that's Shiva. That's why he's called Bole Baba. He simply knows Bole Baba.
And what's the point in knowing? Anyways, he won't do anything with that information.
Aray, he doesn't do anything, yaar. Shakti is doing everything, he's just watching. And he has a choice? You think he has a choice? He just watches, okay. Shakti is great, one new Pushpa, okay. One new Kirti, okay. One new Gayatri, okay. Let's watch. Knowingness. This is called Gottaitappa. And this is the meaning of pouring water on Shiva's head, Abhisheka. So what happens is, pour water on Shiva's head, not a drop of water remains there on the head, it just goes. Like that, water is representing experience. Experience is going over the head of Shiva, just goes through, nothing remains. He is just Bole Baba, watching. Knowing, knowing, knowing. Are you clear? Yes or no? Okay. So, there are tenth millions of experiences in our life. Are you clear? And who is experiencing?
I just
the me is the experiencing instrument. But is the me experiencer? No. Because it's an instrument. So, you say they put a goggle. I am seeing a wonderful movie. Can I say my glass is experiencing? No. Consciousness is experiencing itself. Consciousness is Shiva. Okay. So now the question comes. Every experience leaves a memory. See here. Every experience leaves a memory. Okay. I had a wonderful experience. I went to a movie. Wonderful experience. One memory is left. Experience is over. Okay. Are you clear? Now, why? First, let us take the case of experiencing. While experiencing is happening, okay, can you say, let's say I am just taking a, give me apple. Okay, I am eating apple. Am I experiencing apple?
Yes.
Who is experiencing apple? Consciousness is experiencing itself. But this instrument thinks that I am experiencing it. So memory is recorded locally. This instrument thinks, oh, I am experiencing it. It doesn't remember consciousness. It cannot remember consciousness also, because apple is there, me is there, and consciousness is there. Right? And experience is there. Can you separate out these three, these separately? Can you separate out apple from the experiencing, experiencing from the experiencer, me, and me from the consciousness? Can you separate out?
No.
You cannot separate. It's one single moment. See, I can see apple, right? Apple, the light from apple is coming into my eyes. In my eyes, there's an image formed in the brain. It goes to mind and goes to consciousness. Can I say apple is here? If I cut the light rays, if I remove, I cannot remove the light rays because light rays are connected to apple. Can I say apple stops here? Any point?
No.
It's a single experience. Understand? You understood or not? Can you say that apple is here only? I am separate from apple? The image of apple is in my mind. Right? I cannot say apple is here. Image of apple is in my mind also. So from consciousness to experience, you cannot separate out. It's just one experience, rising and falling. Is this clear? You can imagine it's like a wave in the ocean. One wave comes and goes back. Next wave comes, goes back. Can you say this is where the wave stopped, this is where the sea started? It's one experience. Okay. So consciousness is experiencing itself as one single experience. As apple, as me, and experience. It's one experience. Is there an experiencer here now? Experience and experiencer, is there a difference?
No. Because everything is consciousness. Experience, experiencer.
No. Experiencing is there. It's a verb. Experiencer is a noun. Pronoun is also not correct. There's no noun at all. It's only experiencing is there. It's only knowing is there.
Okay.
If you have to read.
But knowing and the knower are the same.
No. Knower is an entity. Knowing is not an entity. It's a verb.
Okay.
Knower has a history. Knowing has no history.
Okay.
Knowing is a continuous tense. There's a knowing, but no knower. Knower comes with the history, background. She is an instrument.
Knower is also part of knowing.
No. Knowing is an action.
Knower is also known, right?
Knower is also known. What does it mean, known?
It's part of knowing. The knower is also
part of knowing. Now you are confusing me.
There is no knower, right?
There's no, this consciousness, there's knowing only.
In the process of, if you like, take the process of knowing.
No. This girl considers herself as knower. This girl considers herself as experiencer.
Knower is me.
Me.
It's not consciousness.
There is no knower. Me.
Knower is me.
No, you said finally there is only knowing.
Knowing.
Yeah. Me is the knower. Okay. Me, I consider myself as knower, right?
Hmm.
But I am not the knower.
Yeah.
I am considering myself as a false knower.
Then there is no knower at all.
I am telling, there is two things. No? One is in the normal, common man's language, and one is real language. Real. The knower is me. I am eating apple, right? I am the doer. Great. There's no doer, but there's no knowing.
That's what, there is no knower also. There is only knowing.
You have come to one, jump to one next step. There's a knowing. Right? There's no knower. But we have an illusion of a knower. So, madam, you know a little bit grammar. In nature, there is nothing called noun. It's only verb.
Oh.
This language has introduced so much of confusion in our mind.
Officer Helen, I lose my job.
That's the whole idea. Then you can sit here. See, in nature, everything is changing. Okay? So, yesterday's Pushpa is not today's Pushpa. Yesterday's Pushpa, you call us a person. Actually, what's happening is Pushpa-ing is happening. It's a continuously changing phenomena. Me is continuously changing. Is apple same? Apple is also changing. Alright?
Appling.
Huh?
What? It's appling.
Appling. Pushpa-ing.
You said rivering last time in the class.
Is there something called river?
No. It's continuously changing.
It's called rivering.
Raining.
See, there is a question. If you want to take a bath in the river, how many times you can take a bath?
Once.
How many times you can take a bath in the river?
Multiple times, sir. No,
it's only, you get fresh water. Because the water keeps...
How many times you can take a bath in the river?
As long as you're there in the river, you're taking a bath.
River is a noun. What is called a river? A flowing water is called a river. Okay, water is continuously flowing. The moment you dip your finger, the water is flowing.
It's bathing then.
No. How many times? You can do that's a bathing. Bathing. Can you take a bath in the river?
No.
Can you take a bath in a river? Something has to be constant. Your body has to be constant or river has to be constant?
Both are constant.
Body is constant.
Okay, changing.
The moment you put your body, leg in the water, saying your me is changing. Right? Oh, this cold water. No, I put my leg. That's not me, mind has changed. So we have put a leg. Okay, body some 50 cells, half a million cells have died. Another half a million cells have come into picture. The me is changing, the river is changing. Okay, can you take a bath in the river?
No.
But we have an illusion that I'm taking bath in the river because you are considering river as a river, you are converting a verb into a noun. Me into noun. So, a noun is taking a bath in the noun. The bath also becomes noun. Bathing is possible because it's a continuous thing. Okay. Are you getting what I'm saying? Continuously changing thing. The nature is continuously changing. Is there a single moment atoms and electrons and molecules are stationary? Anything in the stationary in the world? Continuously moving. That's called Shakti. It's completely restless. That's what being a restless. So it's a continuously moving. And continuously moving phenomena you call as a verb. A noun. Continuous change is called verb. So in nature there's no noun at all. It's only verb. Okay? But we create an illusion by converting a verb into a noun. Okay, let us say there is a community. They have a language, a special language where there is no noun, only verb is there. Mm-hmm. They will be free from Maya. Because they are speaking reality. Let us say a community is there, XYZ community in Africa. In their language there is nothing called noun, only verb is there. They will never have an illusion of Maya. Because they are not cutting reality into a noun. Noun means the moment you cut the noun, make the noun becomes a frozen entity.
Changeless.
Changeless. When was Pushpa changeless, chainless? Tell me one moment she was chainless.
Deep sleep. When I was
eye. But that is eye. I spoke of only Pushpa. So me is continuous changing, nature is continuous changing. In that changing, where is the stationary? And this English people, English, our language have created such a confusion that they have created noun. Okay. So there is a saying in our this thing. If you take a bath in Ganga once, all your sins will be gone. Right? So now, do you understand the meaning of that? Our ancestors didn't tell just like that. They
okay,
told
you
that
can't
they
take a bath.
You can't take a bath. So if you understand the meaning of that, you'll be liberated. That's what they meant.
It's a puzzle,
riddle. All our spiritualities, all our religions like riddles only. Okay? So there's no, everything is continuously changing. Okay, but the knowing thing doesn't change. The eye never changes. The knowing doesn't change. Okay. So if there's no change also, it knows that there's no change. But it's a knowing, there's no person there. In the meanwhile, what happened? Every experience is stored as a memory. By whom?
I.
Me.
Me.
Every experience is stored as a memory. Okay? This becomes memory 1, memory 2, memory 3, n number of memories, infinite memories. Okay? When the experience is happening, the consciousness is experiencing something and is recorded as memory, and in between two gaps, between two experiences, it goes to the memory. Memory becomes the experience.
Consciousness only puts it into the memory.
Ultimately, you should say consciousness only, but it's put under the name of me. So now what will happen now? There's an experience and there's a memory. Experience and memory. Between the two experiences, there's a gap, there's a memory. In that gap, we'll go to the memory. Who will go to the memory?
Me.
Experiencing.
Attention. So, it looks like a continuous entity. Experience, memory. Experience, memory. Experience, memory.
Okay.
When the experience is not there, you go to memory.
Past.
Yes.
Future.
Who are you, madam?
That's why we say an idle mind is a demonstration.
Who are you?
I'm consciousness.
Oh. So, between two experiences, it will go to memory. Every experience stored as memory. Okay. So, in the process, there seemed to be a feeling, illusion of continuity for me. Illusion of continuity. This is not real me. This is exactly like what's happening in a movie. Slow film is there, no?
Inception.
Movie film.
Yeah.
So if you earlier films you see, hand moving like, it's like a, it's called movie.
Frames.
No, there is one English movie.
I know, Inception.
They dream and they'll go to that state.
Yeah. So you are feeling, you are continuous, not because of experience, but because of memory in between. You fall back to the memory. Okay?
Oh, it's like a filler.
It's a filler. So memory is good memory or bad memory. If you don't have good memory of yourself, you'll think of bad memory of your friend. Why did my friend do that? Neither your friend exists, nor you exist because you appeared and disappeared. In the consciousness, moment to moment. One moment Pushpa came. Okay, that Pushpa had one experience of friend. The friend experience, nice experience is recorded there. This Pushpa has disappeared. Now the consciousness goes to that experience of Pushpa, which is already gone. Pushpa has gone, friend has gone, because they have changed. The experience memory record is there, which is constant. Record is making appearance strong, real. Okay? You are not real. Your memory record is making appear as real. Now is memory real? Is your memory real?
No.
Why?
Because at time and now, when think matter, that will become the memory.
Okay, one beauty of memory is, I can explain more. Early days, they cannot explain. A camera is there. You take a photograph. In the photograph, does the photographer come anytime? Only the world comes into picture.
Before selfie era.
All your memories, you are not there at all. Only me and the other body is recorded. What?
Yeah.
Your me at that moment and other body at that moment.
Other me.
Oh. Is recorded. Now this me has changed. You're one still photograph of that me. This me has changed, that me has changed. But again you say, this is me, and you go back to that me, and that is me, that is that. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Tell me what you do understand. All our memories are record of something. A snapshot of the event. But the event itself is moving, changing. Okay, your friend is not same friend now. You are not same. But your memory says they are same and you are going back, which is going to unreality. Did you understand? Yes or no?
Kind of.
What kind of understanding? Let me tell you. Shardi?
People would have changed, but we would be judging them from our
situation.
No, you also have changed.
Correct.
You also changed.
Everything has changed.
You are also not same.
The other person is also
not same. Everything has moved, but you keep on going back to something which is not reality.
That's like we are in an album
life. Album life, correct. Actually, biggest horror for me, if I go to somebody's house now, okay, they will keep on watching some TV serial. The TV don't want to come out of the TV serial, okay, but the guests have come. You have to keep the guest engaged. So they will be bringing some big photo albums. See. Till I complete the serial, you please watch the photo. So then, they have given that, so I will start opening. Then, after some time, the serial is over. They come. Did you see the album? Yes, I say yes. Did you recognize this person? Take a photo. That photo person is wearing a chaddi and paisam. Huh? You don't recognize that person. It's me. So we are taking still images and say it's me. Still images and say somebody's me, somebody's her. No. They are continuously changing. You are also continuously changing. Where is the stillness? This is called Maya. Then you are actually looking at a frozen moment, which is no longer there. And you are not there in the picture because you are the Sakshi, consciousness. Consciousness doesn't come in the picture. So how much errors you are doing in memory, you tell me. So now engineering students should be able to explain better. Come, my dear, tell. You understood what I'm saying?
No.
Give me an example and let me... give me an example. With the example, I explain.
Okay, so... we're just looking at ourselves through others or something.
Yourself looking at ourselves means what?
Like the me.
Not clear. Yeah. Shardi?
Exactly.
Kirti?
That's confusing for me.
Okay, I'll give you. Example with examples, that makes it very simple. 3 years back, you had a fight with a person called husband. I'll give you a real life example.
Why three years?
In her case. Okay. So 3 years back, you had a fight with your husband called so and so. Who had a fight? Kirti had a fight. So it is recorded deeply in the memory. A horror story is recorded. A horror movie is recorded here. Memory. Okay. Now today also, Kirti requires 5 kerchiefs. Oh, my husband hit me. What you don't realize is that the husband, what you call that dead husband, is no longer there.
He has changed.
Kirti is no longer same Kirti. Kirti has changed. Now, who is crying?
Memory
is not real.
Me.
In memory.
In present me.
Memory, who was recorded? Kirti was recorded. But is Kirti you?
No.
Consciousness you. The consciousness is not there in the record. So you are taking false memory, false record, and crying over that. Understood? Have you understood?
Is it all about controlling your emotions or something?
Mm-hmm. This whole thing has nothing to do with emotions. See, this whole thing...
Crying is emotion.
No, what I'm saying. This whole thing, words called emotions and all, they go to psychiatrists, they teach you. They are in the domain of Maya. Illusion. Okay, you are an engineer, no? What is it?
Psychiatrist
illusion and
aura illusion.
Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. Aura illusion. You have to understand how the functioning happens at a deeper level, not at the surface level.
Okay.
I am telling how the human system is working at the deeper level. Okay. Deeper level, nature, everything is changing. But we are able to take a snapshot of what is a stationary event. But that we start crying, thinking that stationary event is real. But reality has already changed, mood.
Memory
which is unreal.
Yeah,
that doesn't mean memory is useful. Memory is useful because you have to go to the house, you have to go this thing. But the emotional content of memory is false. The reason is, what is recorded there no longer valid. Neither, what's your name?
Kirti.
Nor the husband, nor the relationship, nor the experience is relevant today. Relevant to this moment.
But why this me always remembers bad memories, not good ones?
No, if the me is changing, Guruji, why should it cry? No. Maybe today should be happy about
that.
But
the me is wired, the brain.
Maybe today, something happened 3 years ago, if the me has really changed, it should be happy about that event. At least the emotion should change, right?
It doesn't know, no.
No, it's changed, no. So reaction should also change.
Who is experiencing? Is the me experiencing or consciousness is experiencing?
You are saying me is changing, Guruji. So in 3 years she hasn't changed. Because 3 years ago she cried, now also she is crying.
Is there something constant in this whole thing? Changing?
I is not changing.
I associated with me, Chidabhasa, is the experiencer.
So me is not updated.
No, what she is saying is...
Still in the back.
No.
Version
see,
now.
Yeah, see, she is version 2020. That version 2017 cried. Why will version 2020 cry?
Version 2020 has changed, no?
Changed, so it should not
but who is using version 2020? Who is using version 2020?
Who is using?
Who is the using of version 2020? Consciousness.
No, Gayatri, if version 2020 has changed for the good, then she wouldn't cry.
Yeah.
No.
She has
good or bad, it doesn't apply. She is asking, version 2017 version 2020 are different. Why she should cry?
Because version 2017, 2020 is there, right? So she will remember.
Ah.
I
is getting confused.
I know that, but from that phase she's come, right?
She's saying
2020 includes 2020. Please ask again yourself, between version 2020 and 2017, is there something common?
No, sir, but she is not skipped that, no? She has come from there.
Who is she?
Remember.
Who is she?
The version.
2017.
No, Guruji, she is saying version 2020 has 2017 also embedded.
It's completely changed.
It's changed.